Okay, now that we've gotten some more product applied, things are definitely looking more damp. We can see our microbes first start out here. Okay, prime it. Okay, so yeah, it is really light. So I'm going to go ahead and spray it directly on my curls. I wasn't sure if this was warm enough.
Good morning, my loves. Actually, it is the afternoon, but who knows, who cares? Anyways, I am so happy. Can you tell I'm happy? Why? Because it is Inauguration Wednesday. My heart, I have been so elated all day. I've been watching CNN. I've been watching all the coverage. I am so excited. So much that I decided to open my class today to anyone who wants to take it because I want to do like a Biden Kamala class, and I made the playlist. I'm excited. We're gonna do Eagle Pose, you know, America, which is why I'm wearing my red and blue and a little bit of white in there. And yeah, I'm really happy. I'm so happy. I'm gonna make lunch. First, I'm gonna make lunch. It's dinner time, actually. It's 3:47. I'm gonna have a dinner. I'll show you what I decide on. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be falafel. It's gonna be a Greek something, and I'll show you. All right. I'm craving some Greek food, so Trader Joe's to the rescue. Right now, I have some falafels in my air fryer. Well, I'm the Ninja Foodie, and I'm using this falafel mix from Trader Joe's. Super easy. You just add water, put it in the fridge for about an hour, and then cook it whichever way you prefer. And then over here, I have some dolmadakias, some feta cheese, and some tzatziki sauce. Of course, everything from Joe. I will show you everything when it's plated. I have about 5 minutes left in the falafel, but let's just see. Before, I was only able to make like four because my other air fryer was so small, but thank God for this Ninja Foodie that it is so big that I'm able to make a lot of things. It's amazing. I seriously love when I make something that's super simple but yet so delicious. Like, honestly, all I had to do for this was make the falafels, which was what? Put them with water and put them in the air fryer afterwards, and then just plate the rest of it. And delicious little Greek bowl.
Feel that strength in your back. Exhale, fold one more time. Maybe you can come down to the forearms and just relax here. You want to bring the hands to the floor, do so now. If not, exhale, join me. Arms down, right knee taps the earth, nice and controlled. Taking time for myself, like if 2020 showed me one thing, it's about self-care. Because we were forced to press pause and like focus on ourselves. And if it wasn't for 2020, I probably wouldn't have started therapy again. You know,
I just finished my therapy session and I was talking to my therapist and I was telling her how if I learned one lesson from 2020, it is that I need to take some moments for self-care. And one of the things that I've been doing during 2020 that I'm going to carry into 2021 is doing my nails. And I have been, if you guys saw some of my recent vlogs, I've been buying Olive and June nail polish, and it's gotten to the point that I bought this box on Amazon so I can store all my nail polish in here. And then over here I have like a little drawer to put like all the accessories, and then I have these little dots that I'm gonna place on top of each nail polish container with the color so I know which one each is, so when I put it in the drawer like such, I'll know what they are just by looking at the top. So I'm excited. So this right now is empty. I'm gonna put all these, I'm gonna paint all the caps and then put them here when it's done. Not gonna lie, this was oddly satisfying. It was a little trial and error because I was having some issues, but it turned out really nice. I have some other colors coming in the mail, and then now I know how to do it with no issues. So yeah, it's so pretty. Y'all, it is Friday morning, and I had to share this with you. Another week. And look what it says. It says, you got this, and it's a kitty cat. Oh, hello, kitty cat. Happy Friday! By the way, this is for Thursday, but today's Friday. I do them the morning after, just in case I have any episodes before bed. That would be really sad, putting a sticker and then having to take it off. So, morning of the day after.
So, I'm about to do my nails. It is now
Friday afternoon. I have a client later. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna do my nails and just, you know, have some fun. But I wanted to share with you guys because this morning you saw that I think I'm doing ombre today. So I'm just picking out colors. Like I want to go from light to dark. But this one, yeah. So this morning you saw that I put the sticker on my calendar, which marks 2 weeks since I've had a binge episode. So I'm really excited about that. But it's weird because I do well on one end and then the other end something else is going on. So on Monday I went for a run with Lewis. We ran for 2 miles and that was actually the first run that I've had like in 1 or 2 weeks. And the only reason that I actually went on the run was because he was with me. And my anxiety has started to like take over again. So I told myself this morning, because I wanted to go for a run, and the longer I go without it, the harder it becomes. Like it's just, it grows, like it's like building a wall. And the minute I don't go for a run, that's one brick, and then another day, like it just keeps building and building. The anxiety keeps building with it. So this morning I forced myself, and I use the word force because honestly I did. I wanted to do it. I was scared to do it, but I was like, I wanted to get out there. So I had to force myself to go out there. And of course, once I'm out there, the first couple of minutes, I'm nervous, but it tends to like go away a little. So that was good. But I just wanted to share that because I don't want to seem like everything's going great, you know, like I still struggle with different things. I could be working on one aspect of my life and another aspect is, you know, falling on the back burner. And it's just my anxiety right now. Like I feel bad. My client asked me to officiate her wedding and I initially said yes, cause I, you know, I would love to do that. But the more I thought about it, the more anxious I became and I had to decline, which kind of hurt. I felt really bad, but I explained to her like why I had a decline. And then the following day I had a call with my therapist and I told her, and I was scared that she was gonna tell me like, you know, maybe you should do it because, you know, this is a one way to conquer your anxiety. But she was like, you know what, you made the right choice. She's like, it could have triggered you to have a binge because the way I deal with my emotions, instead of saying how I feel, I eat the words down with food. So I'm happy that she thought it was a good idea that I did that. It helps. It helps to have someone like just say, like reassure you that you're not an asshole and you need to do what's best for your mental health. And even though I would have loved to do it right now in my stage of recovery, I think the anxiety of doing the wedding and like the build up, that wall would have been like, and yeah, so that's that. I think I'm gonna wrap up the vlog here. I just realized that my nails match my pajamas, and yes, I'm wearing pajamas, but I'll put clothes on when I have to train. But all right, I'm gonna go. As always, my loves, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for just listening to me all the time. It's always a ramble here and there. I miss Monday morning rambles. I feel like every Monday morning this goes up, it's like a Monday morning ramble anyways, but that's that. All right, my loves, thank you so much for watching. Remember, it is a new day. I'm so excited. I'm happy. I'm so happy about that. But anyways, thank you so much, my loves, for watching. And as always, namaste. Bye. The stars are moving.